Chapter 39. First Night Watch, Foretop. Stubb, solus, and mending a brace.
Ha, 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 ha!
Ahem. Clear my throat. I've been thinking over it ever since, and that ha-ha's the final consequence. Why so? Because a laugh's the wisest, easiest answer to all that's queer, and come what will, one's comfort's always left. That unfailing comfort is. It's all predestinated. I heard not all his talk with Starbuck, but to my poor eye, Starbuck then looked something as I the other evening felt. Be sure the old mogul had fixed him, too. I twigged it, knew it, had had the gift, might readily have prophesied it, for when I clapped my eye upon his skull, I saw it. Well, Stubb, wise Stubb, that's my title. Well, Stubb, what of it, Stubb? Here's a carcass. I know not all that may be coming, but be it what it will, I'll go to it laughing. Such a waggish leering as lurks in all your horribles. I feel funny. Fala, lira, skira. What's my juicy little pear at home doing now? Crying its eyes out? Giving a party to the last arrived harpooneers, I dare say. Gay as a frigate's pennant. And so am I. Fala, lira, skira. Oh! We'll drink tonight with hearts as light, to love as gay as fleeting, as bubbles that swim on beaker's brim and break on the lips while meeting. A brave stave, that. Who calls? Mr. Starbuck. Aye, aye, sir.
Aside. He's my superior. He has his, too, if I'm not mistaken.
Aye, aye, sir. Just through with this job. Coming.